Hello everybody, Awesome Epic Guys here, and today we're bringing you yet another tier list video. Today, we are rating a bunch of World of Tanks YouTubers. Disclaimer, this video is 100% serious, objective truth. This is just how it is, and there's unfortunately nothing you can do about it, except writing a comment about it in the comment section, of course. Okay, let's go. First off, the mighty Jingles, basically the forefather of the World of Tanks community. A pioneer of his own class, he popularized such means like the Tog, the Doom Turtle, and the KV2 King of Derp. When I think of Jingles, I think about characters such as Jesus, Gandalf, Santa Claus. Jingles is undeniably one of the most legendary content creators of our time, but what really sets him apart from everybody else is that he actually doesn't play World of Tanks. And that's really all you had to say to convince me to put him in a strong S-tier position. Next up, we have Circumflexes. He's been in the game for a really long time, a strong advocate for World of Tanks memes, and a real hefty guy when it comes to pure World of Tanks skills. Personal interests include competitive golfing and being on camera. He's got a thick library of YouTube videos, but he's been in the game for so long that he's gotten kinda tired of uploading videos to YouTube and has shifted his focus completely to Twitch for now. You know, the site with all the family-friendly content. Circumflexes lands in the C tier. C for Circumflexes, of course. Next up, we have Orsonel. You know, Orsonel is a real swell guy. He's all about being calm and staying in the right mindset, you know, Zen and all that jazz. Very respectable. Other than that, he's mostly just farming marks as your average Twitch World of Tanks gamer and uploads his most epic plays on YouTube. I guess you don't really need a thing when you're a god at the game. What really makes Orsonel stand out from the crowd, though, is that he's got a zoomed-in close-up of his own face as his channel logo. You gotta admit, that's a real ballsy move on his end. Orsonel was a part of a big controversy, though, and this might shock you, but what he did was... he actually platooned with Awesome Epic Guys. They are known for being the most toxic content creators on the platform and should be avoided at all costs. For this reason alone, Orsonel ends up in the D tier. D for Dorsonel, of course. Then we have Des Games. You already understand that this guy is an epic gamer from the channel name alone. Two C's and games? Man, this guy is just oozing with pure beast power. Des Games is really good at reading articles and uploading them to YouTube. He also makes it very easy for his viewers to find his videos, thanks to the red colorful arrows he puts in his thumbnails. And I think this is a really smart move for consumers such as myself, who don't really understand anything. When I think of Des Games, I think of Corpse Husband, the YouTuber. You know, he's mysterious, he doesn't show his face, he's got a thick, deep voice, you know? And he's just very smexy. And for this reason alone, Des Games ends up in the B tier, you know, B for Beast Games, of course. Then we have Skill4LTU. You know, he's pretty much the best player ever. He's 3-marked practically all tanks in the game, both on EU and RU, except for artillery, lol, because artillery. And this is, of course, an accomplishment. But what really makes Skill4LTU fall flat is that he's hiding a big, dark secret. He hasn't actually 3-marked any of the tier 1 to 4 tanks in the game. And you know, this just makes me mad. Promoting that you 3-mark every tank, and then simply ignoring half the tanks of the game? That's just hypocrisy on a new level. Come back from your hole when you have 3-marked the AMX40 skill, then I might respect you. Also, he's a fake Russian. And this alone makes him end up in the A tier. A for 3-marked the AMX40, you noob. Then we have Klaus Killerman. You know, Klaus is probably one of the more wholesome World of Tanks YouTubers on this platform. He really enjoys partaking in light-hearted discussions about the beneficial aspects of World of Tanks, and he's a huge advocate for spreading positivity in the community. You know, his personal interests include playing Nintendo games such as Mario Kart, and from that fact alone, you know he's a really sweet guy. He's also very young and handsome, and he's really popular with the ladies. And this, of course, makes me very jealous, and so for this reason alone, Klaus ends up in the Klaus tier. O6 Walst, also known as Honest Gaming.
Motherfucker!
S tier. Sir Fosh. Sir Fosh neither plays the game, nor does he make any content about it anymore. S plus tier. Yeah. Then we have Sophieline. Now, Sophieline is highly controversial because it clearly states in the terms of service that to be illegally allowed to play World of Tanks, you need to specifically be a testosterone-pumped hetero male. But Sophieline ignored his legal agreement and just f***ing plays the game anyways, which is honestly a pretty bold move, which I tip my fedora for. Tip. What makes Sophieline stand out is that she actually like goes around driving real life tanks and shit, and has a lot of insightful knowledge about historical vehicles, which I highly recommend you to watch. She's also sexually attracted to thick, naked German tanks. All in all though, since she broke the terms of service, I'm legally not allowed to place her higher than Orsonal, so Sophieline ends up in D tier. Then we have the Killzor. You know, he's really good at the game and plays a lot of high level clan wars, and he's really and thick, and I'd really like to take him out for dinner and some drinks under a starlit night and just generally have a good time with him and such, but it doesn't nullify the fact that he put the awesome epic ice camo on the Manticore. Nothing wrong with the tank, just the camo. D tier for Daki. Mayland. Mayland speaks German. This is of course highly controversial, since I do not actually understand the German language, and for this reason alone he ends up in the Deutschland tier. New Multi 2K. Oh, Kurva. Honestly, I barely know this guy, except that he beat Zircon in an epic battle in Team Clash, but as a true YouTuber, I'm gonna base my conclusion on half-assed assessments. C tier. Marty Vol. A tier. One and only O16, the Seth Everman of the World of Tanks community. Once or twice a year he makes a wonderful video and then disappears mysteriously. He's also very mysterious himself. He doesn't really show his face. So he's also kind of like Dream, you know, the Minecraft YouTuber, you know, highly inspirational, edgy and cool, you know, super cool, edgy. Yeah. Nice. For this reason alone, one and only ends up in the A tier. Then we have Kems. Now Kems is a content creator I think we can all agree is a wonderful content creator with high standards. You know, when I think of Kems, I think of words such as wholesome, informative, and fun for the entire family. Every time Kems uploads a new video, the community collectively applauds, and it just brings harmony to the entire player base. He's got a very positive perspective on things, and he simply just preaches the good word. Kems is the true content creator, who sees through all the bullcrap and really makes you open your eyes to the truth. A modern messiah of sorts. Kems is the only one worthy of having the S++ tier placement. Truly inspirational. Applause his genius. Then we move over to smaller content creators, such as QuickieBaby. You might not have heard about him, but I felt like I wanted to give him a shout out to boost his channel growth. QuickieBaby is really good at being quick and being a baby. He makes content really fast. If there is something to cover, you know he'll be there covering it. Preferably before any other content creator. He's so fast that sometimes he barely has time to make a proper tank review, and instead just play one single game for a full review of a tank. Sometimes QuickieBaby makes good content, but mostly he's on Twitch grinding for that juicy revenue. Some of his personal interests include neglecting the existence of other content creators and turning down Team Clash annually if he doesn't get paid. When I think of QuickieBaby, I think of words such as "What happened?" and "Please cut that beard." At the end of the day though, QuickieBaby stands at the top of the food chain with the thickest World of Tanks stan base, and this really pushes him into legendary territory. It's PewDiePie, it's Mr. Beast, and it's QuickieBaby that will rule the galaxy in the future. Oh yeah. Truly magnificent. QuickieBaby is the only creator who managed to hit the World of Tanks God tier. I can't believe it. Truly amazing, one of a kind. It doesn't get any better than this. Moving over to larger creators, we have Raging Raptor, who doesn't really live up to his raging name, unless you watch him mauled on Twitch, of course. Raptor does content in both English and German, and this is of course extremely confusing. Consumers such as myself doesn't have the brain capacity to comprehend more than one language, so this makes Raptor's content very annoying. However, most importantly, he has 3 marked the shovel. For this reason alone, Raging Raptor earns a platinum spot in the C tier. CUBTC or QBTC, whatever floats your boat. This is probably the largest and most famous YouTuber on this list. He's a Spanish CC who enjoys playing the game on a relatively casual level, and this is of course unacceptable. Everybody knows that in order to be a real World of Tanks gamer, you need to be 3-marking literally every single tank you play and stream it on Twitch. Truly pathetic. And worst of all, he has collaborated with awesome epic guys on several occasions. This is honestly unacceptable. Straight down to D tier. D for Donde Está La Discoteca? Enviro. Enviro is truly at the top of the game. You see, he figured out that he doesn't actually have to play the game himself in order to publish content, and this is truly genius. You see, instead he borrows clips from a huge variety of Twitch streamers and uploads compilations of them. This is a genius move, worthy of an S-tier placement. But now comes the controversial part with Enviro. He decided that he wanted to play the game himself and make compilations from his own clips too. This is insane. Anyone who wants to actively go through actually playing the game must be truly a madman. This is why Enviro only manages to hit the A-tier. Somebody who managed to do this better is Lacho Woot Replays. Excellent content creator. What he does is he uploads unedited World of Tanks replays several times every single day and gets mad clout for it. I'm not sure if the guy even plays the game anymore or if he has moved to Hawaii drinking martinis on the beach and just lets an automated bot system handle all the replays and the uploading. Not really sure. Wouldn't be surprised if he did it. Truly an inspiration to all of us. Straight to S plus tier for this epic innovator. Second 60 frames per second. I see Second as kind of the EA Games of the World of Tanks community. You know how EA uploads literally the same FIFA game every year but just changes the title of the game every time? Second has taken huge inspiration from this business practice and has basically uploaded the same video. What episode is he on? 338. He's uploaded the same video 338 times. And you know, I gotta respect that because everybody loves EA Games, and who am I to judge someone who takes inspiration from basically the best company in the world? Straight to
EA Sports. It's in the game.
Tier. I, Joxin, self-proclaimed Mozart of World of Tanks. When he's not 100% marking the chieftain, he's probably flirting with female gamers on Discord and Twitch. A true gentleman, I must say. If I, Joxin, slides into your DM, you better be ready to impress him with pictures of Udis. Don't want that chance to slip between your fingers. A true B-tier gentleman. B for I, Boxen. Lemming Rush. E tier. Jeez. Do we really have to talk about awesome epic guys? Like, haven't I already made it clear that they are the most toxic creators on the platform? We have that loud, annoying, toxic asshole who looks like and sounds like Tyler 1, and then we have that depressing 12-year-old soy boy who thinks he's funny while he's actually incredibly boring. And the only thing they do is play the game for fun and make cringy and childish jokes while screaming and complaining about minor inconveniences. On top of that, they make highly clickbait thumbnails and are so incredibly bad at the game that a win becomes a stream highlight. What a bunch of morons. Who do they think they are? We're gonna have to extend this tier list to freaking Z to fit these dumbasses into this video. There we go. Seriously. Screw those guys. And there you have it, folks. The one and only, 100% serious, objective truth, World of Tanks YouTuber tier list. No complaints, no regrets. Like and subscribe. Bye bye.